What's up, everyone? I am Daniel. This is DTV. Welcome to the show. Today's episode will be a testimonial video from a few happy customers that purchased my ultimate PCS checklist right before they moved over to Germany to the US government. So, if you don't know about this checklist or haven't purchased it yet, I highly recommend that you watch this video and subscribe to the channel for more PCS prep content. Now let's move on.
We live in they call it the Castle Complex. So it was once the keeper's house or something, and it's so much more than I expected I would be finding and living in. It is so unique, so German, so not America. I'm loving it. I am Jennifer, and I'm a civilian here with my cat, Sochi. And I work at the Vilsack Behavioral Health Clinic, and I've been here for 2 months.
Before we get started though, I got your birthday present.
Ah, thank you.
So that is like a German startup kit, if you will. So
really?
Yeah, a very startup kit. So you get your bag.
The bag's awesome. Oh, thank you.
Coffee mug.
Oh my gosh, thank you. I don't have one. Oh my gosh. Seriously, I've been using a washcloth. Thank you so much. These are adorable. I did no stumbling. I am a subscriber to the DTV channel, which I recommend. And I was directly emailed it from you. I think it was when you first came out with it, or maybe just after you first came out with it, and I was in a sea of confusion of what I was supposed to be doing, and it was just what I needed. Yes, I must have found your YouTube channel just by searching the name Vilsack. So just that hit to you, probably because of American YouTube connections.
Well, actually, it's a combination of keyword research, amount of content creation.
I started to learn more about living here. Like, it wasn't just touring, it was very practical knowledge about living here that was very tailored to me and what I needed. You know, it was interesting. The videos weren't boring. You know, your videos are very well done. I think anytime I recommended the channel to people, I would say to them, I don't understand why there's this person with such good videography skills making videos for like a very small portion of the world, but I'm very thankful and I love it. So yeah, I learned lots of very necessary things from DTV. I think because it was one portion wrapped up, whereas everything I was getting from my sponsors or from where I would be working was a huge collection of multiple pieces, whereas the PCS checklist was kind of one portion of my life that got to be managed more fluidly in one unit, if that makes sense. And you know, people underestimate how important attractive materials are, like the visually what it looks like. You kind of underestimate what that can do for your eyes when you're stressed out, and the way it was structured kind of added to the ease of how to do it, if that makes sense. The even graphics can go a long way at giving your eyes something to rest on. Yeah, so that's what was different about it. It wasn't chaotic like all the other materials I was getting. He was my number one, and so if I could mess up anything else in this whole process, but I could not mess up him. I couldn't mess up his paperwork, I couldn't mess up the process. It was the one thing I needed to make sure I got perfect.
Yeah, and how did that go? Did everything run smoothly?
It did. The only thing I regret is not looking at the sedatives. He was pretty upset, and it was 28 hours of travel. He wasn't upset, he was just breathing heavy. But I didn't want to do that blindly. I wanted to test it first. So if I had it all to do over again, I would test the medications like a Benadryl and then bring him on that. Okay. There were things I had no idea that are something you bring in unaccompanied baggage. I didn't understand what unaccompanied baggage was. I thought it was more luggage. And so when I read your checklist and it said a bike, the kids' bikes, really, I can bring it, what? And that opened up a whole new section of stuff that I brought. I brought a folding table, a camp chair, my bike, boxes with with utensils, things like that, a couple of towels, a rainbow wig.
What is that?
A rainbow wig. So this made it into my unaccompanied baggage. I don't know how. It was not on Daniel's checklist, but here it is. No, you know what? This is the lesson. You're not gonna get it right. You're not gonna get it perfect. You're gonna forget things. You're gonna put weird things in and wonder why is there a rainbow wig when what I really need is a oven mitt. Yes, because your sponsors cannot cover everything. They're gonna try, and it will be so much coming from one person that your brain can't keep it all straight. So to use your checklist to manage this section simplifies the rest of it. You can say to your sponsor, all right, don't worry, I got this under control. This is what I'm using. It takes a load off the sponsor. It makes things more understandable for you. Blessed are the flexible, for they shall not be bent out of shape. I hope you like camping, because it's several months of making do. And so if you are someone who gets your peace and sanity from your home environment and the objects within it, you're gonna struggle. So you're gonna need to learn how to live with minimal things, repeated uses, but you're gonna be fine. Like you wouldn't believe how often you will run into people who want to help you, because no one here has been here for long. And they all were once where you were, and so they are ready and happy to help you. So don't worry about messing up what you bring. Don't worry about, do not mess up your paperwork for your animal. But other than that, like, you can fix it. People will help you fix it. There's no clicks here. There's no people who don't know what it's like. You're gonna be okay. It really blew my mind. It was almost like this heartwarming, humans are, I love them. Wow. Based on, I've only been here 2 months and I have ride or die. Like, I have people who will, I'm borrowing so much household goods from people who just want to help. They don't even know me and they're giving me stuff. So people are great is the moral of the story.
Hi, my name is Jennifer, and I am an Army spouse. I've been an Army spouse for about 12 years, and I've PCS'd multiple times, but we are PCSing to Germany in July. We only got our orders in late May, and I have been scrambling, trying to figure out how to go about PCSing to Germany. So, I joined a lot of Facebook pages that kind of give you bits of information, and everyone says, look in the search bar, you can find answers on all the questions that you have. But to be honest with you, I'm still working. I've got 2 kids who are heavily involved in sports. There's life continues to go on, and I still have to kind of figure out, along with my husband, how do we PCS to Germany? So I found a great resource, and I really wanted to share it with, everyone who has to deal with a move to Germany, because it can just really get overwhelming. So I downloaded this ultimate PCS checklist. I don't know if you can see it here. And it's just really been a great resource to kind of get me back down to just knowing the nitty gritty, a really just great starting place. Even with common terms, like I said, I've been a military spouse for 12 years, but things like unaccompanied baggage, I didn't know what that was. You do a ditty or you don't do a ditty, you move your, but unaccompanied baggage, what is that? And I had seen people say, well, make sure you bring with you pots, pans, knives, but I'm like, in my suitcase? So it was really nice just to have him have break down the terms, what is unaccompanied baggage? And then moreover, what do you bring with you? Like, what do I take, like, in that first shipment? What should go? So he even has, information about, like, Tupperware. I honestly wouldn't have thought of Tupperware. Things to bring for kids, for pets. And it's like, yes, I'm gonna need stuff when I get over there, because our household goods could take anywhere, from 3 to 4 months to get there. So even things like that, super helpful. Reminders like, we have to ship our cars, or are you going to buy a car? Either way, you need a driver's license. Make sure that your license doesn't expire within that first year. Simple things like that. are, you know, really great reminders, things that you don't think of or you don't have in the forefront of your mind because there's so many other things to do. Setting up a P.O. box over there ahead of time so you can mail yourself stuff if you need to. Just really great reminders like that that, you know, I have found super helpful that I wouldn't have thought of. And I think my favorite thing about his ultimate checklist is the templates. So I print out these templates like crazy because, and I keep them all, and I, but things like even like planning, you know, for the month, you know, your budgeting, your financing. This is, so our unaccompanied baggage is going to be picked up in the next week, and I just started this, and that's why I wanted to stop and talk to you about it, because I was like, thank gosh, I have stuff that I can just print out. I don't have to make a template or whatever. I can print out as many as I want. And so, you know, this is for your home inventory list, but, you know, I'm just starting one now for my unaccompanied baggage, and it just kind of keeps me grounded, and I have everything in front of me, and it makes sure that I'm not missing anything. But even things like passports, okay, if you don't even know, I thought we only needed a travel passport. I had never heard of a no-fee passport before. So not only does he break down the different passports, but he even gives you links to videos that you can watch and, you know, figure out what these different passports are when you need them. So it's a lot of information, and it's really nice just to have a guide that you can just say, okay, what is this? Where should I start? You know, what is the information that I need? And just kind of have a guide to take you through. I mean, look at all this, right? And this is just me kind of being all messy. I have my template spread all over the place because I'm kind of getting down into it on my break here. But yes, so if you are moving to Germany and you don't know where to start and you don't have the time to go to different Facebook pages and look in the search bar for information that you need, I really suggest getting the ultimate PCS checklist to Germany, because it's a great starting place. It's a great resource. So I just wanted to take a moment and share with you. Good luck. And if you guys are going, maybe I'll see you over there. Bye.